हम इस वीडियो में पढ़ेंगे एक्सेलरेशन वगैरह कैसे निकाला जाता है, वेलोसिटी दी हुई है या स्पीड दी हुई है तो एक्सेलरेशन कैसे निकालेंगे, तो इस तरह के क्वेश्चंस हैं, न्यूमेरिकल्स हम आपके साथ डिस्कस करेंगे। टॉपिक क्या है कि क्लास 11th में जब फिजिक्स का चैप्टर पढ़ते हैं मोशन इन अ प्लेन, जिसको हम काइनेमेटिक्स के नाम से भी जानते हैं, तो चलिए कुछ इसमें न्यूमेरिकल्स हैं हमारे साथ वीडियो में, कंसेप्ट बेस्ड न्यूमेरिकल है। पहला न्यूमेरिकल है, ए पार्टिकल इज मूविंग ईस्टवर्ड विद अ वेलोसिटी ऑफ 5 मीटर पर सेकेंड, इन 10 सेकेंड्स velocity changes to 5 meter per second northward, find the average acceleration। मतलब question क्या है कि एक particle पहले किसी direction में 5 meter per second से चल रहा था, फिर वो उतनी ही velocity से लेकिन direction उसने बदल दी। यहाँ पर दो direction आ रही है, eastward और northward। अगर जिसको direction ना पता हो तो पहली चीज तो ये समझ लो, ये direction का map होता है, ये north है, ये south है, ये east है, ये west है, ठीक है। अब देखिए, इट इज मूविंग ईस्टवर्ड, हेलो, तो इस तरीके से आप देखिए पार्टिकल पहले मूव कर रहा है ईस्टवर्ड डायरेक्शन में 5 मीटर पर सेकेंड, तो ईस्टवर्ड डायरेक्शन ये हो गया, ठीक है। तो पार्टिकल मेरा पहले इधर मूव कर रहा है, फिर उसकी वेलोसिटी चेंज हो जाएगी नॉर्थवर्ड, यानी अब ये नॉर्थ ऊपर है, वेलोसिटी इधर चेंज है ना। तो फिगर हमारा किस तरीके से आएगा कि पहले पार्टिकल ऐसे मूव कर रहा है, फिर पार्टिकल की वेलोसिटी ऐसे चेंज होती है, ठीक। और पहले वेलोसिटी कितनी है 5 मीटर पर सेकेंड, और बाद में भी वेलोसिटी 5 ही है। अगर अलग अलग वेलोसिटी होगी तो हम अलग अलग वैल्यूज लिख लेंगे, लेकिन यहां पर ये भी 5 है और ये भी 5। अब यहां देखिए ये 90 डिग्री आपस में बन रहा है, तो यहां पर जो नेट आएगा चेंज इन वेलोसिटी वो ये हो जाएगी, बिकॉज वेलोसिटी इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी, सो दैट्स वाई ये नेट वेलोसिटी हो जाएगा। और आप यहाँ पे पाइथागोरस थ्योरम अप्लाई करोगे तो अगर ये ए है, ये बी है, ये सी है, देन ए सी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू ए बी स्क्वायर प्लस बी सी स्क्वायर, दैट मीन्स ए सी इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ 5 स्क्वायर प्लस 5 स्क्वायर विच इज इक्वल टू 25 प्लस 25, दैट इज अंडर रूट 50, दैट मीन्स 25 into 2 and we ultimately get 5 under root 2 meter per second. So change in velocity becomes 5 under root 2 meter per second. ये आपने निकाल दिया। अब यहाँ पर आपको निकालना है find the acceleration. And acceleration, what is the formula for acceleration? It is change in velocity per unit time. So what is velocity? 5 under root 2 and time आपका कितना लगा है 10. ये आपने 10 से divide किया. That means under root 2 by 2 meter per second square. तो in this way, अगर ये direction basis acceleration के question आते हैं तो हम figure के साथ इसको complete करते हैं। Sometimes questions are given in this format. The position of a particle is this. That means the position of particle is represented using the vector form. And R generally denotes the position of the particle. That means its unit is meter. That means 3 TI, 2 TJ and 5 K. Okay? So I, J, K where unit vectors along X axis, Y axis and Z axis. Now we have to find the velocity and we have to find the acceleration. And it is given in the question the position of the particle. Clear? And at the time 3 seconds. After 3 seconds, what is the velocity of the particle and what is the acceleration of the particle. Now, for that, we know velocity is equal to distance over time. Generally, we know velocity is equal to not distance, you generally written as displacement over time. Okay? Now, in the form of differential equations, we can write it in this way, dv is equal to dr over dt. Okay? That means the position of the particle which is given in the form of vector, when we differentiate it with respect to time, we get the value for the velocity. So, for the first part, for the velocity, the position vector is given 3ti plus 2tj, 2t square plus 5k. Now, when we differentiate dr by dt, listen over here. Don't be confused with I, J and K. These are the unit vectors. Just leave it. Just consider over here, we have the main equation 3t, 2t square plus 5. सी अटेंटिवली, जस्ट आप इसको लिखिएगा नहीं, ध्यान रखिएगा, आई जे के को नहीं ध्यान देना है. यू हैव टू जस्ट सी ऑन द वैल्यूज 3t + 2t² + 5. अब हम इसको डिफरेंशिएट करेंगे. डिफरेंशिएशन आपको पता है x टू द पावर n का फॉर्मूला होता है n x टू द पावर n माइनस 1. यहां पर t की वैल्यू 1 है तो 1 माइनस 1 0 हो गया, तो यहां पर केवल आ गया 3. 3 t का डिफरेंशिएशन 3. अगर हम 2t² का डिफरेंशिएशन करते हैं, लेकिन 2 हो गया, ये वाला 2 ये बगल में हो गया और 2 माइनस 1 हो गया, तो 2 2 4 और t के ऊपर 1, तो मेरा डिफरेंशिएशन क्या आ गया 4t. लेकिन 5 में कोई भी t नहीं है तो इसका डिफरेंशिएशन आ जाएगा 0. तो ये पूरी की पूरी वैल्यू हमने यहाँ लिखी, 3 और 3 के संग i प्लस 4 t, t की जगह ये j और k की वैल्यू खत्म हो गई, दैट मीन्स 0. दैट मीन्स दिस इज द वेलोसिटी. ओके, नाउ दिस इज द वेलोसिटी वेक्टर एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड द वेलोसिटी एट t इज इक्वल टू 3 सेकंड्स. सो वेयर एवर वी हैव t, वी पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ 3 ओवर हियर. दैट मीन्स 3i प्लस 4 इंटू 3j. That means 3i plus 4, 3 is 12j. Now, what is the magnitude of the velocity? What is the magnitude of the velocity? This is the unit vector of velocity. This is the unit vector of velocity because I and j are there. Okay. Now, magnitude of velocity, it becomes under root 3 square plus 12 square. We have to square the coefficient of I and j. So ultimately we get the answer 3 3s are 9 and 144 and it becomes 153 clear meter per second. And for example, if it is asked in the question, find the, this is the magnitude, this is the unit vector of velocity, find the direction of the velocity, then how will you find? I am telling you extra, what is the direction of the velocity? That means we have tan theta generally Vy over Vx. That means velocity vector in the y axis and velocity vector over x. And for the y axis, we have j. And for the x axis, we have I. That means we have 12 over 3, which is equal to 4. That means angle theta is equal to tan inverse 4. So in this way, we can also find out the direction of the velocity vector. So all the three topics, what is the velocity vector? When the position of the particle is given, what is the magnitude of the velocity and what is the direction of the velocity, you can find it very well. Now the next topic we have to consider over here, we have to find the acceleration also. We have to find the acceleration also when the position of the particle is given in the form of vector. Now, see over here, I am going to find the acceleration for the particle. Now we know that acceleration is equal to dv over dt, change in velocity per unit time. So in order to find the velocity, what we have done, r is equal to 3t plus 2t square. I'm just writing by ignoring I, j and k. So dr by dt, which is equal to velocity, which is equal to here 3 to 2 is a 4t. Clear? So this is the velocity vector. So when we differentiate the velocity vector, we ultimately get the acceleration. So in order to, we can write over here velocity vector in this way, 3i plus 4tj along with the unit vectors. So acceleration is equal to dv over dt, which is equal to, now we differentiate this. It doesn't have any t, so 3i get to 0 and here I get 4j vector. So acceleration is directly, magnitude of acceleration is 4 meter per second square. So in this way we can solve the questions which are given in the form of vector. And at 3 seconds, because there is no t, so acceleration is always constant, so its value is 4 meter per second square. Okay. Now the position vector are given in the form of vector along with the trigonometric functions. And we have to find the acceleration at time is equal to pi by 4. And the value of the time is also given using angle. So the pattern is the same, but I am just discussing this question in order to explain how will you find the acceleration etc. when the time period is given in the form of the angles etc. and trigonometric functions are used. Before solving this, I am going to share with you some formulas. Differentiation of cos x is equal to minus sin x and differentiation of sin x is equal to cos x. Moreover, for example, we have cos 2t. Then what is its differentiation? Differentiation of, for example, it is cos ax. Okay? So we write minus a sin ax. Similarly, differentiation of sin ax is equal to a cos ax. So please remember these formulas. These are all very helpful before solving this question. If you know that, it's easy for me. Now, come to the question. We have to find the acceleration. That means velocity is equal to dr by dt and acceleration is equal to dv by dt. That means the position vector is differentiated two times in order to find the acceleration. Now, position vector r is equal to 4 cos 2t I plus 4 sine 2t j plus 6t k. Okay. Now velocity, that is dr by dt, is equal to, now cos 2t, that means 2 we take outside along with minus sine, 4 2s are 8 sine 2t I vector. Okay. Now here 8 cos 2t unit vector j, 60 k, that means 6 unit vector k. So this is the velocity meter per second. Okay. Now acceleration, which is equal to dv by dt. So we again differentiate it, minus 8 to the 16 cos 2t I minus 8 to the 16 sin 2t j, and here there is no t, so k gets 0. So this is the value of the acceleration. Clear? Now we have to find the value of acceleration at pi by 4. That means at the place of t we write pi by 4. So we get minus 16 common cos 2t I plus cos sin 2t j. Okay? Minus 16 cos of 2 into pi by 4 plus sine of 2 into pi by 4. Okay, this is the. Now 2 into pi by 4, what does it mean? That means pi by 2. Okay, so cos 90 and sine 90, it becomes cos 90 and sine 90. Cos 90 plus sin 90 j. Now value of the cos 90 is 0, value of the sin 90 is 1. Okay, so only j vector is left over here. So what is the answer? Minus 16 into 1 into j vector, that is minus 16 j meter per second square. Now the next question, this question is of different pattern also. A particle starts with a velocity of v is equal to 5 I cap meter per second. A particle chalta hai, uski velocity hai 5 meter per second. And moves in xy plane and produces acceleration of this. Ye acceleration produce karta hai. Yani koi particle hai jiski velocity ye hai aur uska acceleration ye hai. What is the y coordinate of the particle when x coordinate is 84 meter? That means we have to find the position vector now. लेकिन साथ ही साथ क्या है कि एक साथ नहीं दिया हुआ है, यहाँ कोई t वगैरह नहीं दिया है, ना velocity में ना acceleration में. अगर ये t दिया होता तो हम इसको integrate करके हम इसके particle position vector पर पहुंच जाते. लेकिन इस question में आप देखिए, चाहे वो velocity हो चाहे वो acceleration हो, यहाँ पर t vector नहीं दिया है. तो हम इसको इस क्वेश्चन को कुछ अलग तरह से करेंगे. लेट पोजीशन वेक्टर इज, वी हैव अ फॉर्मूला एस इज इक्वल टू यू टी प्लस हाफ ए टी स्क्वायर. ओके, सो this position vector that is r, this is u is the velocity, that is phi I, and this is t time. Now half acceleration vector 3i plus 2j and t square. Okay, now this we get the position vector. So whenever the velocity and acceleration, they do not have t coordinate along with that, and the position vector is not properly given, we can find out the position vector in this way also. Using the formula, distance is equal to ut plus half at square. Now, if we differentiate, it becomes 5it plus half 3it square. This is I vector. And I is the x vector of the position vector. And j is the y coordinate of the vector. So, y coordinate of the vector becomes half into 2j into t square. ये जो i वाला है, ये i वाला, ये i वाला, ये x position vector हो गया. और यहां देखो j नहीं है, ये j है. j वाले तुम्हारे y position vector हो गया. अब ये इक्वेशन बनी 5t प्लस 3 बाई 2 टी स्क्वायर. दिस इज आई कंपोनेंट ऑफ एक्स वेक्टर. क्लियर? एंड एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट इज 84 मीटर. एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट इज 84 मीटर. सो वी राइट इट ओवर हियर, 84 इज इक्वल टू 5t प्लस 3 बाई 2 टी स्क्वायर. एंड यूजिंग दिस इक्वेशन, क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, वी ट्राई टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ टाइम. Okay, so multiply it. 2 4s are 8, 2 8s are 16, 2 5s are 10t plus 3t square. Clear? I'm going to rub that. I'm going to rub this portion. Okay. Now, 3t square plus 10t minus 168 is equal to 0. Now, b square minus 4ac, which is equal to 100, plus 4 3s are 12, 12 into 168, 12 8s are 96, 12 6s are 72, 81, 12 1s are 8, 12, 20. 2016, that means 2116. Pause for it. Now we get 2116. So when we solve, we ultimately get 18 and 28. By after multiplying, we get 211. Yeah, 3 into 1 into 16 is equal to 3 into 168. And after subtracting this, we get 10. Okay, 18 and 28. So when we write 18 and 28, we get minus 18t plus 28t minus 168 is equal to 0. 3t take common. T minus 6, 28 we take common, T minus 6. That means T is equal to minus 28 by 3 and T is equal to 6. So, here time we take is 6. Now we have to find the Y component for the particle. So, we put in the value for the Y component, half into half JT square. Half and half get cancelled, t square, that means 36 j. This is the y component of the particle. Now x component of the particle becomes, we have 84, because when we write t over here, this is x component. So x component is what? 5t plus 3 upon 2 t square. We put the value of t as 6. That means 6 5 is 30. 3 by 2 into 6. 3. 9. 3 is a 9. 9. No. Not 6. 6 is a 36 we write, because it is t square. So when we get 18, then we ultimately get 3 is a 24. 54. That means we get 84. Okay? Clear? So the velocity vector becomes 84i plus, what is the value of I? Y we get 36. 36j. Okay? Now one more question is there in the question. Find the speed. What is the speed? The magnitude of velocity and speed are same. So we find the magnitude of velocity, and this is the value of the speed. You solve this and try to find the value of the speed, which is in meter per second. I hope the content of the video you like most. If you want to watch some more videos, just WhatsApp on the number which is running on the video, or just click on the description box. Thank you.